He says, this week, now here's the story. This week, a raging issue has generated passionate debate among many Ghanaians, both on social media and in the traditional media space, TV and radio, has been in respect of a report confirmed by government that the spouses of President Nana Akufo-Addo and Vice President Dr. Mahamudu Bawumia are to be placed on a monthly salary. The spouses of Dr. Mahamudu Bawumia are to be placed on a monthly salary at the level of cabinet minister. So the reference is to Samira Bawumia and Rebecca Akufo-Addo. That's the reference that President Mahama makes. Okay, let's move on. He says, we are told that the 7th Parliament of the Republic of Ghana, which was dissolved at midnight on January 6th, approved the recommendations in the report of the Presidential Committee on Emolument for Article 71 office holders, chaired by Professor Ya Intiamua Bedu. The news, particularly at this time of austerity, this now comes into the real important political talk, says the news, particularly at this time of austerity, has generated some level of outrage among the populace, and I can understand the anger of those opposing the recommendation of the Intiamua Bedu Committee and its subsequent approval by Parliament. See, so President Mahama says here that the news, particularly at this time of austerity, has generated some level of outrage among the populace. Okay, it should be made clear also that the recommendations in respect of spouses in the Intiamua Committee report, which covers the years 7 January 2017 to 2021, is solely in respect of spouses of the President Akufo-Addo and Vice President Bawumia. The challenge, however, is that the spouses of the President and the Vice President are not captured among Article 71 office holders, and therefore there's no legal or constitutional basis for it. It should be noted that the recommended salaries for the spouses in the Intiamua Bedu report are captured as part of the emolument of the President and the Vice President. This seems like an attempt to sneak the first and second ladies into the Article 71 office holders. But here's a bit of contradiction, because President Mahama, in the same statement, says that the allowances to the spouses is captured under the office of the President. He said that in this very document. He said the allowances is captured under the office of the President. And then he comes back here and says that those people are not, first lady and second lady, are not Article 171 holders. And therefore, it looks like something is being sneaked in. And he says this is clearly problematic. So we have to interrogate that a little bit, because President Mahama, in giving us the institutional history of the matter, tells us that the spouse's allowance, including his time as president, and his time as vice president, the spousal allowance is captured under the office of the president and the office of the vice president. But he's concerned that in this particular regard, in relation to Samira Bawumia and Rebecca Akufo-Addo, they are being sneaked in as Article 71 office holders. But let's move on. Okay, the Intiamua Bedu Committee report rightly makes the case on page 51 of its report as follows. The committee knows that neither Article 71 nor any of the provisions of the Constitution bestows benefits on spouses of the President and the Vice President. Similarly, no legislation mentions what the state should provide for the spouses of the President and the Vice President. Yes. Okay. The question then is, this is President Mahama asking, if the committee recognizes the above and therefore appreciates that there can be no legal or constitutional basis for seeking to bestow any such benefits on the spouses of the President and the Vice President, why then did it proceed to provide for the payment of the monthly salaries pegged at the level of a cabinet minister to both the First Lady and the wife of the Vice President who served in the period 2008? Because they were capturing it under the office of the President. They did that. The committee must have done that. Having announced that the two ladies were not Article 71 office holders, and with the precedent, as President Mahama tells us, that it is captured under the office of the President, the committee was capturing those salaries under the office of the President, the expenditure under the office of the President. So an appendage of an Article 71 holder is the spouse, because the history from the Atudazi has told us that spouses should be remunerated. Okay, is that also? Maybe you disagree with me. Let's see what you think. All right, let's move on very quickly. And why did Parliament also approve it? As has been reported, this approved this recommendation without any review. Okay, it says Article 71 is an entrenched clause. Okay, so that's President Mahama speaking about this matter. So now the controversy is raging and people are talking, and so the MPP people start and they are equalizing. They say, no, Mrs. Lordina Mahama has also collected the money. After President Mahama speaks, now they are publishing documents about how much Mrs. Lordina Mahama continues to receive as a former vice president, how much Mrs. Matilda Ayamita Atta receives, Mrs. Liman is receiving, Mrs. Achampong is receiving, Mrs. Akufo is receiving, because they were concerned that the document is presented as though it is just Samira Baumia and Rebecca Akufo-Addo. So that's the goes on. And then comes the big story. Let's see, this is Akufo-Addo's letter. So Mr. Akufo-Addo eventually writes and sets out, this is the letter that Mr. Akufo-Addo writes, and we'll put it out properly so you can see it. It says, the attention of the First Lady has been of the Republic, Mr. Akufo-Addo, has been drawn to the recommendations of the committee established pursuant to Article 71, the Intiamwa Bedu Committee, which, among other things, seek to regularize the payment of allowances to spouses of the current president and the vice president, former heads of state, president and vice president, respectively, as part of the privileges due the president and the vice president under Article 71 of the Constitution. The First Lady has taken note of the ongoing conversations in the nation, following on from these recommendations and their bipartisan approval by Parliament, as mandated by the Constitution as the body which approves the emolument of the executive. So these are emoluments of the executive. Okay. It is important to state that the payment of such allowances existed and was made to previous First Ladies in the course of the Fourth Republic, prior to Mrs. Akufo-Addo becoming the First Lady. Mrs. Akufo-Addo did not request to be paid any allowance. She only received that which existed and attached to her status, albeit informally. That notwithstanding, the public discussion has been laced with some extremely negative opinions, in some cases, which she finds distasteful, seeking to portray her as a venal, self-serving, and self-centered woman who does not care about the plight of the ordinary Ghanaian. Okay. In view of this, the First Lady, in consultation with the President of the Republic, has decided to refund all monies paid to her as allowances from the date of the President's assumption of office, i.e. from January 2017 to date, amounting to 899,097.84. The First Lady has also decided not to accept any monies that have been allocated to be paid to her pursuant to the recommendation of the Intiamwa Bedu Committee as approved by Parliament. She is doing this as a purely personal decision without prejudice to the rights of others and not to undermine the propriety of the process undertaken by Parliament. Now, this is a very important part of the information. It's a very important part of the letter written by the First Lady. It says that she's doing this purely as a personal decision. So those who are saying, calling on other First Ladies to return the money, the First Lady has something for you to listen to. She says she's doing this purely as a personal decision, and she's also doing it without prejudice to the rights of others and not to undermine the propriety of the process undertaken by Parliament. This is a very, very important paragraph in this document. Okay, the First Lady does not want these matters to serve as a distraction from the good work that the President, who is currently touring the Savannah and Upper West region, is doing to develop our dear nation. That's another very important one over there. Okay, let's move on. It says that the First Lady will continue to support the President, as she has always done, in the execution of the mandate entrusted to him by the good people of Ghana. So this letter came out and it sort of completely changed everything. People didn't know how to react to it. The first reaction I saw, which was in very bad taste, was the complaint that she had used the coat of arms to present the letter. This is a First Lady presenting the letter out of the office of the President. They said she had used the coat of arms. I mean, people were not concerned anymore about the money. People didn't seem concerned anymore about the economics that we're talking about. People didn't seem concerned anymore about her so-called selfishness. Now they were complaining about the letterhead that she wrote. Hassan, you said something?
The letterhead.
Yes. Now they were complaining about the letterhead. Why did she use coat of arms? I mean, I think that Ghanaian youth should be very serious. We should be very, very serious in this country. We are not pussyfooting and we are not, quote unquote, misbehaving about. We are thinking about the future of a nation. So we complain about money that is going to First Lady because we are saying that it's insensitive, it's this, it's that, it's that. Then she says that I don't want to take the money anymore based on everything that's happening. And one of the early comments from people who are mobilizing people for a better Ghana, it says that, why did she use the coat of arms? Are you serious at all? I mean, what's going on in your head? Is that the point? Anyway. Anyway, as long as guy is laughing at the person. Okay, so that's the first lady's first letter. And then there were others who said that, well, you have written a letter and evinced an intention. That's not enough. After evincing the intention, let us see you actually do it. So that also came as a challenge to the first lady. And then here is the second letter that was signed by Shelley Lai at the office of the first lady. Now let's look at the letter in detail. It says, I am directed to forward herewith a consolidated Bank Ghana Limited check number 00 for an amount of 899 being the full refund of monies received from 7 January 2017 to date as allowances given to Her Excellency the First Lady of the Republic. Okay. As disclosed by the statement issued on the 12th of July, Her Excellency the First Lady of the Republic is refunding the amount stated above and also takes this opportunity to decline any allowances to be paid to her in future. Her Excellency the First Lady remains committed to her role as First Lady and is devoted to her charity work, championing the well-being of women and children in Ghana. Please accept, Madam, the assurances of our highest considerations. It's a letter signed by Shelley Lai, who is in the office of the First Lady. So that sort of concluded the matter. And then the politics began. We will not participate in the politics. We'll go to Hassan Ayaga and ask him those questions. What's the politics? The politics is that people are saying that Lordina Mahama, former First Lady, former Second Lady, must also return. But you heard Rebecca Akufo-Addo say that she's doing this without prejudice to the rights of other people. Lordina Mahama has a right to keep the money. Lordina Mahama has done some work. She has a right to keep it. Mrs. Akufo-Addo says that she is in the hot seat right now. She doesn't want this conversation to distract or detract from the work that her husband, the president, is doing in carrying out his development agenda for Ghana. So she has taken a decision to move. And then as soon as she did, a letter also came from the office of Samira, and that was a much shorter letter. And it is also says that Samira Mahama is also returning the money. So both Samira and First Lady have done so. Let's read Samira's letter. Okay. The second lady, H.E. Samira Baumia, in consultation with H.E. the Vice President, will refund all allowances paid to her since 2017 and will not accept any monies allocated to her, pursuant to the recommendations of the Professor Ya Ntiamua Bedu-led committee, as approved by Parliament on 6th January. Samira continues, says, Mrs. Baumia continues to be committed to the service of the nation to deliver humanitarian interventions and initiatives in the areas of health, education and economic empowerment. And the letter is signed by Kwame Chum Esquire. He's a senior aide to the second lady, Samira Baumia. And both of them have now decided to take to return the bid.